Hi there, and welcome to this GEOLayers 3 tutorial. We'll be creating this graphical route animation here. In fact, this animation can be looped. In this tutorial, we're gonna have a look at how to connect features within the feature browser. We are going to draw animated features to our map. We'll have a look how to animate an arrowhead perfectly along a route feature. And we're gonna learn about some very handy functions of GEOLayers and how to animate our view. All right, let's get started by searching our features. We're gonna need Lyon, and we wanna have the city. You see this here. So I'm downloading the second feature here. And our destination is Geneva. So I'm gonna add this also to the browser. Okay, cool. By selecting both and double-clicking it, holding shift, we can fit the view to like the two cities. And as we have both of them selected, we can sort of connect them with this feature here. So by clicking it, we got a few options here. We could like connect it with a straight line. We could have a plain route, which is the shortest way on a sphere, which like in most cases is sort of this curved path. We can do like a pedestrian route, a bicycle route, and we want to have a car route. And once I click this, we get this feature collection with a line and a bunch of like points, which are maneuvers in fact, but we don't need them. So I'm gonna remove them and I'm gonna select the line feature and drag it on top here. So we can remove the feature collection. Cool. Now we got all the features we need. So let's create a map comp. I'm gonna hit create map comp, call this route loop, hit next. And we're gonna use Stamen Design's beautiful toner background, which is really great. It's like simple, only black and white, and I really love this style. There we go. Let's start by drawing our first city, Lyon. I double click it to fit my view and the map comp's view to Lyon. Now GEOLayers created some styles here for us based on the colors that we have. I'm pretty cool with this screen. So I'm gonna hit draw features and I'm gonna draw Lyon to our map. The next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna animate our route here. Therefore, I'm gonna jump to our starting time, which is 5 seconds here, and I'm like trimming the work area to the 5 seconds and selecting the feature. I click draw features and I click the second option here, animate feature path. So once I hit that and I select this layer and hit U, we can see that there are some keyframes. And as we have a closer look to our map here, you can see that this route is actually animating. It is pretty thin though. But what we can do, we can select a different style here, which has like a bigger line width, and hit swap shape layer style. All we need to do is select our shape layer and click that button. And as you can see, the line is now a lot thicker. Now let's go ahead. This is gonna be cool. I'm going to the starting point of my animation, of my like route animation. And what we wanna do is we wanna animate our view along this route. We got this option, fit view to feature. And with the route selected, we got a few more options here. And there's animate view along feature, which is pretty much exactly what we want. So I'm gonna click this one. And what GEOLayers now did is it created keyframes on the latitude and longitude animation properties of our map comp. And we're now perfectly smooth following this route. Now let's draw Geneva. Oh, I selected the wrong style, but there's not a problem with that. By holding control and clicking the style, this pop-up will not close, so you can keep it open. Like, yeah, it's just a little trick. And I'm gonna hit swap shape layer style here. There we go. And we have the fill color on our city here. I'm gonna shift the starting point to the beginning of our comp and drag it below our route here. I'm also changing the blending mode to multiply. Like this, we can see like streets and stuff from the map imagery through. I would like to add sort of an arrowhead to our route here. Therefore, I'm using the star tool. I'm going to create a star here. And with that one, with that shape layer selected, we can simply swatch the shape layer style, and I'm opening up this polystar group, and I'm changing the points to 3 here. This gives us a perfect triangle. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to scale this a bit down, like 8% probably. That's a good size though. Now, we want this layer to follow our root feature. So the first thing, I'm going to shift this layer to the point in time where our animation is starting. With this layer selected, I hit pin layer to feature, but of course we're going to select our root feature here. But we're now going to pin shape layer 1 to this feature, and in fact we're going to animate it along the feature. So once I click that and hit U, selecting this shape layer, you see there's a lot of keyframes. And what they are doing is they're letting this layer follow our route. But you know, it's an arrow, so it should change the rotation according to like the direction of our route. And we can do this. So by looking at the effect controls of our layer here, we can see like a bunch of things. The geographical position is keyframed here. We don't need to touch this. We don't need to touch the offset. We actually don't want to scale it with the map, but we want to rotate it with the map. And in fact, what we need to do, therefore, is we need to make this layer 3D. Then we can rotate it with the map. And if this one is checked, we can also rotate it along the path. Now you can see that it's rotating in the right direction, but we need some sort of offset. So we can simply do this by setting this bearing offset to 90 degrees. And we created this pretty cool arrow animation here. But I think it is a bit too fast. So I would like to change the duration of the whole animation of our pinned layer, of our root, and of our mapcomp view animation. So what we can do is we're going to select all the keyframes we want, and we're holding Alt and dragging the last keyframe. And this will, you know, extend all the keyframes in between accordingly. Like this, we can pretty easy extend the animation duration. Okay, that's a better speed for me. Now, to make this thing loop, we're going to somehow need to come back to our starting city. I'm going to jump a bit ahead in time here. Click the keyframe button to keyframe all of our like animation properties. To have like sort of a break here, and then from here on, I'm going to select Leon, click Fit View to Feature, and I'm going to use the last option here, Animate View from the current view to the feature we just selected. And by clicking this, we have this nice animation back to Leon. Again, I'm going to select my keyframes here, hold Alt, and drag them to fit the duration that I want. Okay, so this is already a very nice animation. But we can make this animation more interesting. And what we're going to do, we're going to add some pitch to our map. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a full rotation of our bearing here. So I'm going to go to the loop point I want to have, which is here. I'm going to like trim the work area to this. And at the starting point, I will simply put a keyframe here with a full rotation of our bearing. And like this, we have this very nice three-dimensional animation here, which puts a bit of motion to our map all the time, and which will loop perfectly. Great. Now let's do some details. I would like to make this arrowhead pretty much appear. So I'm going to go 10 frames ahead, and I'm going to keyframe the scale here. I'm going to ease those keyframes by pressing F9. And as we reach our destination city, I'm going to do the same thing, but the other way around. I'm going to simply scale it down to 0 here. The next thing we're going to do, as we fly back to Lyon, we're going to trim this path back to 0. I'm going to also easy ease this. So as we fly back here, our trim path is back at 0. Now, all we need to do is hit finalize. GEOLayers does its thing. It's going to download the imagery. It's going to blend the zoom levels and all that stuff. What I'd love to do as a last point, I'm going to add labels to our two features. I'm going to shift them to the start of our composition here. And there we go. Now I'm going to do one more thing to bring some more color in here. So I'm going to add an adjustment layer here. And I'm going to add color balance to it. And we're going to do a full hue rotation from here to our loop point. So this is going to change the highlight color of our map along the way. There we go. That's how you create this three-dimensional looping route animation. And to do this, we learned how to connect features in the browser, how to draw animated shape layers, how to animate an arrowhead perfectly along a route feature, and we learned about GEOLayers functions to animate our view. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.